The shooter who put this community on edge is still on the run as families return to Three Oaks Park in Lee County. Hello, I'm Russ McCaskey.
I'm Amanda Hall. Today we're speaking with people coming back to the park as deputies work to find out why someone would fire several shots into a parked car, killing a man in broad daylight. This is the scene yesterday, and you can see all of those deputies converging the entire scene with the crash car. Wake News reporter Annalise Iraola joins us live at Three Oaks Park. Annalise, are there any new leads deputies are working with?
Amanda and Russ, the Lee County Sheriff's Office says it's making progress in regard to their search for a suspect. Now telling us they're looking for one male suspect, but detectives are working around the clock to find out who shot and killed a man here at Three Oaks Park yesterday morning. Day after, this normally quiet park was on lockdown.
I got up to where the light stoplight is right over here, and the police had the road cordoned off so you couldn't get down.
Bob Mansfield, here with his grandson, was turned away Thursday. So was Lawrence Barnett.
We were coming down the road, and then cops were flying in and kind of stopped us and told us we couldn't come anymore. And we were asking what happened, and they wouldn't tell us, so we knew it was something pretty bad.
That bad thing was a deadly shooting. The sound of gunfire caught on a nearby Ring camera tells part of the story. The Lee County Sheriff's Office says a man was shot multiple times in his car at Three Oaks Park. He drove it into this median where he died.
Upset for the people that had a loss, but shocked. This usually is a really quiet area, so it was really surprising and disappointing too.
It's tough. I mean, obviously you never want to see anybody go that way. You never want to see anybody go anyway. We feel bad for the family because loss is tough. But yeah, it was shocking.
LCSO says their detectives are making progress, now saying their suspect is a man. Few other details are being released at this time about the investigation or the description of the suspect. As of now, LCSO says they don't need the public's assistance, but if that changes, they'll work with Crime Stoppers to get that information out. As soon as we have any new updates, we'll be sure to let you know. Live at Three Oaks Park, Annalise Iraola, Wink News.